From the 121st Psalm, you read, I lift up my eyes to the hills, from where does my help come? My help comes from the Lord, the maker of heaven and earth. The Lord shall preserve you from all evil. It is the Lord who shall keep you safe. The Lord shall watch over your going out and your coming in from this time forth forevermore. From the book of Deuteronomy, it is recorded, the eternal God is your dwelling place and underneath our everlasting arms. Let us pray. Almighty God, source of all mercy and giver of all comfort, we remember before you today, dear Clifford Halbert, in your boundless compassion, console us in the Lord, give us your aid, so we may see in death the gate to eternal life, that we may continue our course on earth in confidence until by your call we are reunited with those who have gone before us. Make us aware of the shortness and uncertainty of human life, and let your Holy Spirit lead us in righteousness all the days of our life, in the confidence of faith and the comfort of hope, in favor with you, our God, and in peace with all humanity. Amen. In the Holy Scriptures, we find comfort in the biblical visions of the future. In our vision from the book of Isaiah, we read, on this mountain the Lord of hosts will make for all peoples a feast, and God will destroy on this mountain the covering that is cast over all peoples, the veil that is spread over all nations. He will swallow up death forever, and the Lord God will wipe away tears from all faces, from all the earth. But if you go to completely the other end of the Bible, in the New Testament, from the Holy Scriptures to the New Testament, we find another beautiful vision of the future, like Isaiah's vision. In the book of Revelation, it's recorded, I saw the holy city, the New Jerusalem, coming down out of heaven from God. I heard a loud voice speaking from the throne, now God's home is with humankind. He will live with them, and they shall be his people. God himself will be with them, and he will be their God. He will wipe away all tears from their eyes. There will be no more death, no more grief, or crying, or pain. The old things have disappeared. Gary Halbert has passed on out of this life at the age of 68 from this world we so often think of as our permanent home. He now rests until we shall all join him in this final experience, which the world calls death, but which we are assured in the Holy Scriptures is just a sleep. I counted the days that Gary was blessed with, and they numbered 25,133 days. The psalmist in the Holy Scriptures writes in Psalm 90, we spend our days, each one of us, as a tale that is told to teach us to number our days so that we may apply our hearts.